back.
Okay. Hello. My name is Shunsuke Fukuden, and I'm a 3D designer. I'm from Japan. And today, I would like to talk to you about how to create a 3D model for ColAR. Okay, so firstly, I'll do my introduce of myself briefly. So I have 6 years work experience in Japan for several computer graphics company as a 3D designer. And at that time, I'm doing lots of many things. So for example, here is my sample reference video, what I'm done in Japan. It was a bit too old. I mean, it's been already 2 or 3 years ago, but maybe you can see what I've done. This image is not real time. Everything is pretty random. It's just one part of my job. But in Japan, a 3D designer requires many skills, not specialist, but generalist. So I have to do kind of a whole things, modeling, rigging, animation, rendering, and compositing, lighting is also. Yeah, but it's okay, but if you wanted to be a specialist, it's a little bit different story in Japan. Anyway, in Japan, I came here, and from 2009 to 2011, I worked here. I worked here and mainly worked for Magic Book. Probably you can see that one. That is also, I did it. Magic Book and the Virtual Campus project and ColAR projects also I did. And here is a Virtual Campus project promotion video, kind of. So this is geography building, and I made it inside of the building. And the difficult part was there is no height there, so I just took my photos, and from the photo I judged the height and create textures or something. Yes, and now I came back here and working on the ColAR project. Right, so next is, okay, a little bit more about Japan. Probably some people worrying about a nuclear disaster. And it's still working on the after treatment of Fukushima Daiichi nuclear plant. An electric company said it will take 10 to 30 years to clean up, but not confirmed because there is no experience everyone to do like that. But if you have a chance to go to Japan and worry about radiation, there are probably it can help some information you can get from this website. Here is a 24 hours monitoring post data you can see. And the square dot is a monitoring post. And the data is showing like this. Yep, so let's see the Fukushima area. It seems very high. Yeah, like this. So this one is around here is a restricted area. You can't go inside. But anyway, like this. And also, United States Force Japan announced for the family who are staying in Japan. And you can read that information in English. Like this. And then let's see the Tokyo area. So if you have a child, you can check the influence of the child. So here is a US Army's announcement. So like this, yeah, radiation inspect. And like how much radiation dose is allowed to kids or something. Right. This is about nuclear disaster. And also I found something, funny videos, and I would like to show you. Some people may know that. Okay, Japan has many otaku people, and sometimes their design create interesting things. If you don't know the otaku name, I'll get the definition from Wikipedia. Okay, otaku is a Japanese term used to refer to people with obsessive interests, particularly, but not limited to anime, manga, or Japanese video games. So, these guys are made of something funny and I think it's probably I think it's embedded from Java system. And it's a direction and diagonal. And can detect. And combine the camera. And Kid Love also doing his similar things. And the work integrated. So hair and movement. Real time. Obstacle instruction is also up there. And other one is a little bit more radical, I think. That's funny. This guy is, I'm not sure the researcher or someone. Probably just fan of, like AR things. He created himself something. Also using Kinect and head mount display. And using detection or tracking system. And Kinect and head mount display combined together. Something, I think it's really creepy, actually. But he went to the outside as some kind of college. But character is you can see him now, virtual character on the outside. Character is already set to stop or something. Animation. And also, obstacle is calculated by the depths of the map. So he can hide it, as she can hide up, up over the, up on it. Behind the tree, she can hide something like that. And also, this guy is. Yes, integrated some interaction with a 3D character. So I think kind of creepy and probably bored or something. But that's pretty interesting. I think these guys has to need to come here and improve their skills for more interesting. This model is also driven by physics. We have time off. It's about it's small talk is over. Okay, let's do its main menu. And for making a ColAR model, I think I could say that there are six steps. So first step is 2D page design. It's very important. Modeling, second step is modeling. And three is UV setup. It's texture map coordination. And number four is rigging. And five is animation, and six is combat. This is for 3D designer has to do for the ColAR. Okay, and the first stage is 2D page design. This case is a 2D design is provided from a customer or a 2D designer. In that case, 3D designer can start modeling immediately by using like this. The lights. Light side penguin is used for ice festa, I think, occurring. This is provided from a customer, I think. And the other case, there is no 2D page. Image and also wanted to make an original page or something. In that case, 3D, to create a 2D page, 3D model has to be using a 3D model, and 3D model has to be finished modeling and rigging beforehand. And generates a contour image by using a toon rendering method, then give it to the 2D designer. This one is a contour image, and using this, the 2D designer modified the image because this one is not quite good. There is missing eyes and the summary line is not connected properly. So in here, Katie did lots of things. And here is a final image. So this left side is the designer put a line or a detail, eyes or something. And the right side is it's also created from a 3D image. And yes, add some line or design. Then we get a 2D page. Right. So next step is modeling. In this case is it's based on a 2D design. Okay, create the model by using a 2D page. Create the model, okay. Rotoscoping is useful technique. Rotoscope is just using a reference image when you're modeling. I'll show you later. Left one is it shows wireframe 3D models, and then background is a reference 2D page and creates models to fit the image. And how to interpret the 2D information as a 3D structure is the most difficult and creative part of this stage. That's not easy, but it's fun for me to imagine what kind of a structure this 2D character have. So something. Okay, and if once finished the modeling, next step is a UV setup. And this is one of the most tricky part of this project. Although the 2D page shows one side of the model, the 3D designer has to set the UV to the entire model, including the backside. So left side of images shows a UV map. And then each dot related to the polygon's vertex. So it's kind of a map. So let's see the first step. For ColAR, the camera projection is a good start to create a UV map. But of course, it causes a problem, especially backside of the model. Camera projection is using a texture, and from the camera, you can look the camera and assign the UV to the character. So front side is okay, but the back side is also shown the head or something around here. The shoes design is strange. So. Next step is modifying. So modify the UV. And if once modify the UV, the character will be look like this. And the backside is also work properly. So the important thing is to decide which line should be remained. And from time to time, it is necessary to check the distortion of the texture and try to keep the texture image properly as much as possible. Okay, let's see the soft real data. Okay. And so this is a character. And as you can see, the 2D page gives only a front image, but character is moving, animated. So I have to assign the UV map, even the back side. It cannot see from this page, but using the same image or similar part. So modify that UV. So here is this around here is just a front hollow mark, but it also can see in the backside because I assigned around here, this around this area, to the around here, this area, and. And okay, let's see. And the 2D design is including a contour as a line, black line. And some line is necessary to remain, like this part. This is, if you remove the line, the detail is kind of missing. So 3D designer has to decide which line is important and which line is not important. For example, yes, here this is arm part. But if you remain the black part, oh, yes, arm is like what's over here, like this. That's not good. So UV setup is actually quite tricky, but has to be done properly. Otherwise, it causes a strange result. For example, this 2D image not show the gloves, but I have to assign a texture, so I put the UV for the gloves on the shoes area. So if you can move like this part, the color is changed. But so just put around here. And then when kids painted on the shoes, automatically the gloves is also painting this color. OK, so this is UV map. Right. Next is rigging. For the animation, the model needs to be set the bone structure and assigned skinning. To make the control rig is also very useful. So this is, normal procedure for making a 3D model. So okay, let's see. This one. So this character has already animated, and the bone system is like this. Yeah, you can see like a straight line, but this is called bone. So each has a specific area defining the position. For example, this one is a forearm, and this one is a waist, as a chest. So it's like a human bone. So this is called bone system, and skinning is just like this. Okay, wireframe. So each vertex has information about how much get the influence from the bone. For example, this point, this vertex, has been influenced by chest bone 3%, pelvis bone 30%, the waist bone 66%, or something like that. So whole vertex has some similar information. So head is just a head bone or something. It's 100% working. This is a weight map and cold skinning. Okay. Right. So 3D designer create like this system, and also for the animation, it would be good to create a control rig. This control rig allows to easy to access the animation, so you can change it easy to. You can move the character easily and freely, something like that. Hey. Okay, so this is a color rigging and animation. For ColAR, we can choose many methods of animation, such as keyframe-based animation and simulation also. But all movement must be baked into the object transform for converting. That means, for example, this character's hat ribbon is at this moment driven by spring simulation, simple spring simulation. So it's not I'm not controlling at all, but just calculated by the software. But it cannot export like this movement without change to the transform information. So for example, like this head model has a animation key set. So this one is quite a traditional style of the animation. So here is a 20 frame. The rotation X is minus 4.9 or something. But a simulation has not such keyframe. Just simulated, it's generated movement by software. So when you finish the animation once, you have to bake the animation to the like bone system. Then you can export. Okay, so here is some sample which I've done for the ColAR. This is a lion in the middle. And a little bit old model, but yeah. So for ColAR, I made it like this animation. And this one is what? This one is a dragon model. Including a background, I create models. And the dragon model is, it was a pre-mated. And animation has already assigned it. So it was very easy to create a ColAR book. So then animation finish, then convert. ColAR software required OSG format for the animated and static model. The format is reliable, but the data size becomes huge when the animation length is long. And it is necessary to check the exported data if it's working properly or not by using OS Viewer. And if everything is fine, handing the data to the programmer, and then 3D designer's work will finish. So let's see the OSG data right here. This is the OSG viewer, and this is OSG file format. Actually, its size is really huge, 137 megabytes. OK, Okay. So this is yes, doing all the animation characters data. Yeah, so you have to check the animation and the texture issues. Yeah, some part has probably maybe problem, but almost okay. But you can check something strange or not. And then if it's okay, yeah, you can hand it to the programmer. Oh, I think yeah, that's it. Thank you. If you have a question, anything is okay.
In your area, what's most important, the artistic appreciation or the technical skill to do the things?
For ColAR?
Yeah, in general, the things that you did before and this time.
Talking about ColAR, main design is provided by the other person, like a KT or a customer or something. So at that part, I'm not quite need to, I don't need to real imaginative things. But when you have to create a 3D model, probably you need to kind of imagination because it's just 2D page. Yeah, that's only 2D page provided, but you have to think as what kind of a structure they have and what kind of a movement they do or something like that. That part is probably difficult, but I think that part will be a kind of a artistic part.
Models, you know, there are not dragons in real life, and the dogs are not anthropomorphic. So what happened when you want to do something that it's an imaginary character, so it should be realistic, but
you don't
have any reference to be realistic, because, you know, again, the dogs have not this like a dog, or they don't have arms, or so I guess it's a main
Actually, not really, because you may see many animation or movies or something, even dragons or imaginary creatures that are walking around and already, and you can get lots of reference from that from the internet, and think it's really original may be very difficult, but almost all models have. Maybe we can find at some reference. So it's not such a difficult.
Now with these new cameras like you have that can capture 3D, can it work? You see like that, like most part of the maybe that you do, maybe you can really take advantage of using this camera, or you think that there are a lot of things that the camera cannot provide. For example, if you want to model like a house or something like that, maybe now you can take like this 3D camera and start scanning.
You mean this this video or something? 3D detection.
I think you want to ask if you are able to frame up with something and you get 3D model.
For example, what is the challenge now, for example, because whenever you take the 3D points, you are missing still a lot of things that you are doing when you, for example, as you say, assign each point to the weight and these kind of things. Just wondering how you see this new approach of like start modeling not by scratch or taking a new device like a camera. Steps, or you still would prefer to start everything from scratch?
Basically, you mean it's a kind of an obstacle things, occlusion or something? I'm not sure, but Basically, I'm just using a 2D page, and camera is used for, yeah, for the 2D page, just for the 2D page. So I think maybe I'm not quite get your question, but for example, like this hand model has hide in the Scott. Yeah, but camera used, I mean, web camera using for this page. And but I need to create the models. So the difficult part is probably difficult, but it's still I can enjoy it to make part of a imaginary part or something. Is that correct? Or you were talking about
More about the real
real world.
Real object that you can use the 3D cameras and then can
real object.
Can import into
David is talking about like you can right now the new techniques that we use like Kinect. Real 3D the 3D mold for the real objects without any UI. So we can generate the 3D mold for the real object just use the Kinect. And is there any influence on your on the way you work in the future?
Kinect is I'm not sure it's a probably you can use it for modeling, but at this moment, Kinect is, it's not good for modeling. It's just good for probably animation. Some people create a plugin for a motion capture system by using Kinect. Some 3D designer tried to use that things just for animation, but not for modeling. Like a loom is, probably you can get some kind of a texture and the models from the camera using a z-depth or some depth data. But the result is just a little bit messy. I mean, data is quite messy. Some part is unnecessary polygons or something, and normally, it's really huge data because it's a point. Basically, it's a point data or something. So, 100 million polygon or something, and it's still messy. So, 3D designer recreates the models. It will be a guide, but maybe the 3D designer has to make from scratch same things. It's kind of a same thing. It's probably it will be a guide. But
it makes no sense, I guess, because you want to create imaginary objects, usually, when you're modeling, you know, dragons.
Yeah, but sometimes you want to create realistic things.
For example, when you are developing a game, and you want to.
Yeah, but anyway, you need to add another stuff in the thing that you capture, you know, like costumes.
Then, for example, if you want to, like, scan this room, and then you can, from this, you can have steps to that.
The skeleton or the bones of the animation that you want to do.
I think someone can do it. Like this, but it cannot use it for. Yeah, it's kind of a messy. It's lots of polygons, and it's just a small polygon that has made it.
And fixing that, it will take more time than creating from scratch.
Yeah, probably, but I'm not sure someone doing a much better to get a much better result. Like this, it's all made by the point things. Yeah, point data. And it's really huge, and it's not quite useful for the real time or something. And especially game using limited resources. And they are very strict about number of polygons or data size. So I'm not sure. Yeah, in the future, probably. It's very possible. But at this moment, we don't use this like this data. Just probably some people using it for a guide. Yeah, this one.
Thank you. Can't interpret the camera like the Kinect, because Kinect is a very low quality camera. The existing 3D cameras with some archaeological work and so on, they can really create a nice high end polygon model. But they're very expensive.
Yeah, yeah. And also, the camera projection is always, they always create some hiding point. It cannot see from the camera or something. So if people really want to create a much easy way by using a camera, maybe you need a 3 or 4 camera and took many directions, then it works. But for the human or something, a small object is OK. It's already done it. 3D scanning system has already released, and a human body or a human face has already using, but not Kinect, but it's a 3D camera. It's from 360 degrees and captures data and create 3D and a texture in the same time. But in a game company, game company sometimes using these data for the guide, but recreating everything anyway, because it's not a good for a real-time system or something. It's too heavy or too complicated or something.
Any other questions?
Okay. Thank you.